If you're editing buttons in your apps or websites one by one, you are doing it wrong. In this video, I will show you the right way to create an interactive button with the default, hover, and pressed state, and also why you should use it as a component instead of a simple object. Let's start by creating a new button. Select the text tool and type button. Then let's turn this into an auto layout, hitting Shift A. In case you want to know more about auto layout, watch the video appearing in the corner at the right hand side of the screen that I've made for you. Let's also add some fill color. We don't want white, so let's pick this purple right over here. Add rounded corners, and we can turn it into a component. So head over here and click this icon to make it a component. And there's our button component. But let's say we also want an icon to use in some specific cases that we don't need text. So we can copy one from our component library and paste directly into our component. Since it has already auto layout, it will auto adjust the icon in the button. Pretty cool. So we have the button in the default state, but we need hover and pressed state. You can have more status, but for this video we'll use these three. If you look here again, you may see this icon with a plus. That means you can add a variant of this component. Let's click, and now we have two buttons, and we can press it again, and now we have three variants of the same button. Now we can rename property to button and the variants to default, hover, and pressed. And let's change the fill colors of each button to differentiate the states. Let's use these purple colors that we have here. So if I now drag one of these components, you can check that you can change the button state right away. Next up, we need to add animation to these states. So select your prototype in the top right corner and click and drag from the default button to hover button, and I want that while hovering. Smart animate with ease out effect, and we can keep 300 milliseconds. And from the hover to pressed button, I want that on click. Smart animate with also the ease and out effect of 300 milliseconds. Now we can drag our default button to this frame and set it to flow starting point, so that when we hit play it will start here, and let's go. So if we hover the button, it goes to hover state, nice. And if we click, it changes to pressed state. Pretty awesome. Okay, but what happens if you need to scale this up to websites and apps? Why is this relevant to create components? Let's say that you created a website, but the client now wants this purple button to be orange for some reason. If you didn't make it a component, you need to go one by one and change the style of it. Very, very boring and time consuming. But if you make it a component, look at this. You just need to change your main component to the new style, and automatically it will change everywhere you have the instance of this button. This is so cool. And if in some cases you need the button with the text and others only with the icon, you can also configure that. And if you want to know how I've added these properties here to the button, go check the video appearing here on top that explains how components properties work and how to create them. So yeah, creating objects that will be repeated across your websites or apps should be turned into components so that you can easily update your designs. And that's it. I hope this was an helpful video. If you liked the video and you're not yet subscribed, please take a moment to like and subscribe the channel. It will mean a lot to us. See you in the next video. Thank you and have a great day.